somebody who was in despair, somebody who was troubled, somebody who wanted to reach another level, that you might supply that which they need. We thank you for our preachers, our deacons. We thank you for how the choir, some of the musicians that played, the waiting congregation that waited patiently for your word. Now, Lord, we need a word. We need to reign. We need a blessing, dear Father, from you now. Now, remember our young children, our young adults, dear Father. Remember our mothers again of the church. Bless us and keep us now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The 40th Psalm.
Death song. My daughter, Minister Bond, she's preaching for a great friend of ours at the Methodist Church
down in Shadyside this morning. They're having a big day there, so I've asked her to come back for that great gathering of that church. So we thank God for Pastor Matthews, who's a great friend of this church. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see some of them. Pastor Matthews, a great friend of the family and her church. Next year, I hope we can even invite that male chorus to come and be in this great day. From the 40th Psalm, David speaks to us. He says, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He brought me up also out of an harbor pit, out of the mountain clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my going. And he hath put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear, and many shall trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man that maketh his Lord his trust, and respecteth not the proud, nor such as turn aside to lies. The Lord continued to bless his blessed word. You may be seated. Kindly fix my mic. Kindly give me that feedback. Tell Randy to get the feedback out. Amen. I waited patiently. I didn't rush. I took my time. And waiting, I didn't get upset. And my brothers and sisters, and a good way to be patient is to meditate while you're waiting. Meditate on the goodness of the Lord, what he has already done. And it'll make it easier in waiting. We all get impatient sometimes. I said we all get impatient sometimes. And people seem to just pry on many times our patience. I know nobody mess with you now. Your patience is strong. You can wait it out. For me, sometimes my patience is short.
You get real.
I'm praying that the Lord Jesus give me more patience to wait on some things that is deserving to me.
My God.
My brothers and sisters, many times people are impatient. They want to grow up before their time.
Been there.
I said, have you been there? Didn't you want to be grown before you got grown? My mother used to say, you're smelling your little musk.
Smelling
yourself. Besides, impatient. You want to grow up too quick. Impatient and getting married. Otherwise, we want to see. I want to get the first thing we see, because we're not patient enough to wait on the Lord to fix it up. Impatient in getting many things. Many impatient in getting the car key, drive, and He and Absie would want to get a call. Jim patiently calls, you won't wait until the Lord bless you that you're able enough to get that call home. Impatient on waiting on a job. Many times if you waited just a few days longer, that job might have been a better job than you have. Impatient in having children. You can't wait to give somebody that cigar. Brag on that you have a daughter or son. And my brothers and sisters, I believe we would have less divorce if we wouldn't be so quickly to get married. But we are impatient. We're impatient and divorce come before we eat up the cake. David said, I waited. He said, I waited patiently. Many things will happen while you're waiting.
Yeah.
But he said, wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he would strengthen our heart. But David said, a good way when you're waiting and seem like things are not coming your way, he said, make a cry.
Mm.
He said, I cried unto the Lord.
Yeah.
Have mercy.
Yeah.
Hold me, O Lord. He said, according to thy tender mercy.
Yeah.
He said, I'm the one that comes short. He said, blot out my transgressions. Sometimes we forget that we have sinned.
Amen.
And come short of the glory of God.
Yeah.
And we are too impatient on things to go down and have a little patience on God. Yeah. We don't want God. We want God to wait on us, but we don't want to wait on God. Yeah, but if we learn to let God have his way, everything will be all right. David said, I waited.
Yeah.
I wasn't impatient. I waited patiently, and he preserved my faith. And let me tell you, if you wait, God will preserve some of your faith.
Somebody.
And that faith, while you're waiting, will bring you through. How many know if you hadn't waited on some things, you would be in the graveyard today?
Yeah.
Otherwise, he reserved your faith, and your faith worked out your trials and your tribulation. How many know that God had brought you out?
Oh, yeah.
Look at somebody that may be discouraged and say, he brought me out. Let it be personal. Say, he brought me out. King David knew about suffering caused by his own action, but he knew he could turn to in the time of trouble. And it's good to know who you can turn to when you're in need for something.
That's right.
You got to know who to
turn
to. You can run to your friend, they can have money in their pocket, and they won't help you out.
Yeah.
They can have some good encouragement and won't even encourage you to hold out just a little bit longer. But David said, a man after God's own heart. He was a man after God's own heart. He said, I learned how to wait patiently on the Lord. He said, I made it a point to seek the Lord in my difficult days. I made it a point not to run somewhere and try to get somebody else to help me, but I have a helper right beside me. He said, I can look to the heavens from whence comes my help, because all of my help comes from the Lord. I know where your help comes from. Maybe your help comes from your money. Maybe your help comes from your friends. But all of my help comes from the Lord. There's an even in his action and was unfaithful to the Lord. He said, God brought me out of something. Even when I had the rock killed, God still brought me out. God will bring you out. We'll kill many people with our mouths. We might have not physically killed them and put them in the grave, but our mouths and the way we have done, we have killed the spirit of many people that would have had a good spirit, but because of your mouth.
Yeah.
Put them in a graveyard and still go to church. He knew by trusting God, God would deliver him. He said, in the time of trouble. And I don't care who you are, every now and then you're going to have some trouble. Trouble, you're going to have to live for trouble. Trouble will look for you. And trouble will knock on your door. Trouble will talk to you. Or trouble will box you. Trouble just is trouble. And trouble comes for one thing. He comes to make trouble. He said, but David said, in the time of trouble, he would hide us in a secret place, in the pavilion. God has a sacred place where your enemies and your foes come up against you to wipe you out. God said, I got your back. I got your side. I got your front. You don't have to run. He said, I'm able enough to handle things for you. All you got to do is stand still and let me show you something. And if we would let God show us something sometimes, God will show you how things can work out in your favor. He opened it out, church. He brought me out of some things that I never thought I could come out of. And God knows you. I don't care how deep you are in sin. If you go to the Lord, He will bring you out of that. I don't care if you're a good Christian. I don't care if you're on drugs or alcohol. If you want to come out, God will bring you out. But you want, you need to ask God, I need to come out. David said, I waited patiently, and he inclined. Otherwise, he heard me. He heard my cry. You got to cry loud. You can't mumble this thing. Sometimes there comes a time you got to open your mouth. And open it wide like a trumpet. A trumpet makes a sign. You got to let the enemy know that you're on this track. You got to let the enemy know, I got to make this sound because I'm ready for battle. But I found out that many Christians are not ready for battle because they have not put on the whole armor of God. And when the devil comes and trouble comes your way, you don't know how to fight the devil on his own ground. Sometimes you got to go to the devil's camp. Sometimes you got to go to the devil's house. You got to go to the devil's house. Sometimes it comes that you got to go and take back that bitch the devil has taken from you. It's time to take back your money. It's time to take back your children. It's time to take back that friend you had. I wanted to be brought out. And he brought me out. And he said, that's the reason I'm standing today. Because I was able to call somebody I know. You got to know him in order to know how to call him. It's not by fancy words. It's not by using a lot of eloquent things to try to get through. But God can use the simpler things and make the wild man look like a fool. I tell you, my God that I serve, He's waiting for somebody that is in trouble to be brought out of some condition that you've been in a long time. Somebody ought to look at somebody today and say, I'm coming out. This is my day for coming out of this mess. I've been in it too much. I've been staring in it. I've been laying in it. I've been wallowing in it. But I'm coming out, and God's going to bring me out. David said, the reason I know he can bring you out is, he said, I thought the Philistine Goliath, the great giant they had, and I know he can bring me out. I was just a little red. Only that got me. They tried to dress me up, but how many know you can't fight the devil in his own clothes? When I fight the devil, I got to have on my war suit. Sister Gumbel, I got to put on my war suit. God got a war suit. When you put on your war suit, you can go on the devil's ground, and you can fight the devil on his ground. Oh, David said, oh yeah, I'm just a lad, but I'm going out, and I'm going to fight this old giant. Yeah. Well, I'm going to ask you a question.
Yeah, bring it on down. Help us.
If you're scared, and there's some giants in the church. y'all miss that. I said there's some giant devils in the church. And if you're not able to put on your war suit, you need to take it off. God give you a garment, a white garment, whatever color garment it is, for the fight the devil, and you fight him with the Holy Spirit by the power of God. The Bible said, put on the whole armor of God. We lost the battle against flesh and blood, but on principalities, powers, and high places. If you got it, come on, let's fight. It's time for Christians to flow like a butterfly and sting like a bee. When you get to the devil, flow and sting and knock him out. Did he say he brought me out? He said, I got these five smooth stones, but I didn't even just three in. One hit the mark. But God give you something that the Holy Ghost will hit the mark. All we got to do is when we stand in the congregation of the righteous, you speak the word of God, and it can hit that devil right in the forehead and knock him out. And when you knock him out, don't leave him to cut off his head. You cut off the head by using the word of God day and night. Pray, pray, and pray. Let me tell you, when you kill one, there's another.
Yeah.
The brother heard it. Brother David killed his brother. He said, I'm going to get him.
Yeah.
I'm going to get him. But see, when God is for you, who can be against you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They made up a song, Saul killed a thousand.
Yeah.
Oh, they killed 10,000. They got mad, they got mad, they got mad. People don't like to see you wipe out the enemy. But let me tell you, when you got the power over the enemy, this church should not be under the power of any kind of enemy. You got power that God gave you. Jesus didn't go to the cross. He had to lay down his life and go to the cross and go in a grave for us to be some scared Christians. Saul tried to kill him.
Yeah, preach.
Saul got mad.
Yeah.
Because they said David was stronger than he was.
Uh-huh.
But you know you can't kill that which God has made alive. Do I have any alive people in here? Because the Bible says that the dead. You got to be alive to be on this battlefield. I don't want no dead soldiers, but I want soldiers that can march up the chain highway. And the further we go, the better we feel, because we're marching up Zion Hill.
Yeah.
He would tell me, he brought me out from all of that.
Yeah.
He said, I'm still here. When I went, he said, when I went, done all of this, I thought the Lord didn't know me. I thought he had left me. But one thing God will do, he'll take you back and try you. If you want to come back and try you over. David said, I done this, I knew what to do. He said, I prayed, have mercy unto me, O God. According to thy tender mercy and thy loving kindness. He said,
blot out
all of my transgression. He said, and I want you to wash me from my iniquity and cleanse me from all of my sin. If you do this for me, then I can walk right. People think walk right because they're wrapped up and tied up and tangled up in so much sin. They're not drunk on liquor, but they're drunk on sin. And sin got staggering, and they can't go front or backwards because sin has taken over. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Then he said, I want you to do this. Create in me a clean heart. Don't you wish people had a clean heart? Don't you wish people would just tell you the truth when they smile at you and shake your hand, help you, act like they love you, and when they in their heart, they hope you would fall over and die, but thank God, God's got your back. Created me a clean and renew. I want to say
it's all right.
But I lost. I let this woman.
Yeah.
I let this woman get to me. I went up to her. Let me tell you, man, it's terrible to go up high.
All right.
And look over and see something that is mighty tempting. Yield not to temptation.
Yes,
for yielding. You see, you got to be saved. You got to be sanctified. You got to be Holy Ghost filled. When a beautiful woman, a beautiful man walk by you and your heart don't flip. You might be 90 years old. They're just as great as it can be. But there's something about temptation that carries you back. When David said, I once was young. But now, I'm old. But David said, in all of my years, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. I see David bread. Otherwise, David is saying, if you stay with the Lord through all your trials, through all your tribulation, when you get old, we'll make you young. And when you get young, we'll give you some knowledge, and some will bring you old. So when we look with compassion and say, Lord, what you wanted me to have, I thank you.
Right.
It's not how the look of my looks of a car is red and shining. I want that.
Yeah.
And it's no better than the black car or the green car.
Yeah.
Be content. Be satisfied with what God has given us. Or he'll take that little bit that God gives us. Or he'll bring us out of a lot of things that we have put ourselves in. So when you're thankful, the Bible says, over a few things, he'll make you rule over many things. David said, I pray, restore unto me the joy. Let me tell you, when you got some joy, my brothers and sisters, you can't help but smile and put on a good laugh. Throw your head back and just thank God for the joy that you have on the inside, because the joy that you have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. You might try to take my joy, but you can't take my joy. God gave me my joy. God gave me my happiness, and I'm going to hold on to it, because the Bible said, don't let no man steal your joy. People are trying to steal your joy. Oh, I they can't sing, or they can't preach, or they can't talk, they're trying to steal your joy. But however God sent you, be like Moses. Moses said, I can't even speak. God said, don't even say that. I got somebody. Oh yeah, I got somebody gonna speak to you. All you got to do is tell him what to say, and he's gonna go and say it for you. My brother and sister, if you can't say a word, every night and then, just wave your hand, and God will fight your back. To do is pray. David said, I prayed, and he brought me out of a horrible pit, out of that miry clay, and placed my feet on a rock, not like this, and established my going. Where are you going? I'm just walking with the Lord. Where are you going, Eden? I'm just walking with the Lord. Remember when Enoch, the preacher, the Bible said he walked with God and was not, because God just took him. The Bible said that God walked with him. We don't, it didn't say exactly what God was saying, but in my spiritual imagination, I believe God was bragging on him. Said, Enoch, you've been a good man. And he's walking down the road and walking and talking with Jesus. And you kept my commandment. You've done what I told you to do. You preach in season and out of season. And after all, they stopped. And I believe in my spiritual mind, you know, said, I need to be getting back, Lord. I'm a long ways from home. And I believe God told him, you've come too far now to turn around. That's the reason the Bible said that God took him. He took him right there. Took him with him. Isn't it good to walk with God? Because you never know when God's going to call you home. Walk with the Lord when you're sleeping. Walk with the Lord in your daily walk. Walk with the Lord, especially in the church. Whatever you do, let it be real. Let it be real. If you're going to live for God, live for him. If you're going to sing for the Lord, sing for the Lord. If you're going to pray, do it for the Lord. Pray for the Lord. And he will bring us out. It's my brothers and sisters. You got to realize if you want to come out, I'm about to come. Some of you get to sleep. God is good to us, even in the time of trouble. He promised to bring us out of these things. And I'm glad we must turn to God and wait patiently for his help. Anybody ever had to wait on a check? You didn't get it until you got there. Well, you're not going to get your blessings until you get there. Some of you prayed to sit down the blessing and got your umbrella up. Flip that umbrella, turn it upside down, and say, fill my umbrella with your blessing. Oh, look to the hills from which cometh your help, because Lord, your help. Are you going to get blessed? Showers of blessing, and you got an umbrella. Turn it upside down. Then I'm going to fill my cup. And then it overflow. We must turn to God and wait patiently on him. Our patience will test us. I said, patience will test you. And if you say you're not a patient, let me preach too long. Let me stay in the church too long. First thing you said, ain't got much of preaching in the world. Now, I got to get out of here. And what haven't we got there? Who you hiding from? Hold your head up if you got to leave. Hold your head up and walk around. I forget now all of my benefits. My brothers and sisters, even in the time of trouble, God will bring us out, but we must turn it over to God and wait patiently for his yourself. Our patience will be tested and will be tried, but if we'll try through the fire won't burn you, the flood won't overtake you, because God has already went through there and sent Jesus before you, and if he went through there, I know I can follow. Where he needs me, I will follow. I'm going with him always, even to the end of the world. Learn to trust God while you're going through the storm. We can glory in tribulation when we learn how tribulation works patient, and patient works experience, and experience works hope. Well, I'm going to tell somebody, I've got the hope today that my hope is filled with nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I got the hope, a sweet of rain. That God will bless somebody and bring you out of the things you didn't want to do. Too long, you've been crying for too long, you've been sorrowing too long. The Lord is working that underlies that cancer, that rheumatism, that disappointment. All those things that you're not to care for, I'm going to bless the Lord.
Just
stand. Please stand now as we offer an invitation to discipleship. It's not convenient for you to stand, but we may give you an opportunity. If you're not saved, if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, this would be the moment, this would be the time that you could come out and you could tell others that He brought me out from a horrible pit and establish my feet. Now I'm walking into the newness of the Lord. If you're here today as a candidate of baptism or the Christian experience, come by.